Filipinos in flood-hit United Arab Emirates appealing for help from the government. Three OFWs were killed while two others were wounded following one of the heaviest rainfall in the Gulf region's history. The Philippine Consulate General in Dubai says the still high water level hampers their efforts to provide aid and food supply to Filipinos in some parts of the country. Despite this, they vowed to exert full effort to ensure the safety and comfort of at least a million Filipinos in a UAE.
Ang mga naapektuhan po nating mga kababayan, minsan sila po ay tumatawag sa amin, hindi sila maabot ng tulong sapagkat meron rin pong dahilan rin po sa tubig. Talaga pong na-overwhelm ang UAE ng sa lakas at volume ng tubig na bumagsak. Pero we are in touch with them. Yung iba po nagsasabi, we have 3-day supply na lang ng pagkain, 2-day supply. Pero nagko-coordinate po kami sa kanila and we're hoping na habang bumababa yung level ng tubig, kami ay makakarating po sa kanila. Ang maganda po naman dito ay, as I said, we are in constant communication with them at sila po ay ating na bibigyan naman ng necessaryng ayuda.
The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration also assures the families of the victims. The government doing its best to repatriate the remains of the three Filipinos killed in the floods. Dubai Airport has canceled more than 1,000 flights, while roads remain badly flooded as of Friday. The damage to agriculture brought by the prevailing El Nino phenomenon in the Philippines nearing the 4 billion peso mark. The Agriculture Department reports rice crops took the biggest hit with losses reaching 2.36 billion pesos. Despite this, the agency does not see a significant effect on the country's rice production as it expects a good harvest season. As for the farmers group, the Federation of Free Farmers, it wants to see more effort from the DA to fight the effects of El Nino, especially as it eyes a bigger budget for next year. The agency has said it plans to ask for a 100% increase in its budget next year to modernize farms, improve food security, and increase earnings of farmers and fisher folk.
Hingi yung department ng malaking budget. Pero where is the output? Where is the result? Hindi namin masyadong makita kung saan. Siguro ginagastos naman nila, pero para baka hindi tumatalab yung mga intervention. For now, very limited yung choices natin dahil we are at the mercy of nature.
A former Philippine finance chief weighs in on possible solutions to the country's economic woes. Economist Gary Tevez says there is a need for the government to amend some laws if it wants to improve the Philippine agriculture sector. He adds removing restrictive economic provisions in the constitution and further reducing tariff cuts on imported rice and other food items will help the country fight inflation and attract more foreign investors.
Ngayon, meron tayong pagkakataon, although nagkakaroon ng konting resistance, sana mabukas na rin yung ating matanggal na yung economic restrictive provisions sa ating constitution. Hindi kaagad ang makikitang immediate solution, pero ang sitwasyon natin, pantay-pantay na tayo sa ating mga kasamahan sa Asia na wala tayong mga restrictions sa constitution. Doon na ang labanan sa legislation, paglagay ng mga limitations, safeguards at iba pa. Malaking bagay na signal sa ating foreign investors na imbitado talaga sila na pumasok dito sa Pilipinas. Sa tingin naman, pwedeng magkaroon pa tayo ng adjustments para makatulong sa pag-encourage ng more foreign investors dito kasi yung ating mga incentives hindi pa kasing pantay. Iba natin mga kasamaan sa ASEAN po, Henry.
The power grid of Luzon remains on alert today, Saturday. Philippine grid operator, the NGP, says Luzon's power grid will be under a yellow alert status from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. It adds 22 power plants in Luzon are on forced outages, while another is running on lower capacity. A grid is put under a yellow alert status when the operating margin is unable to meet the transmission grid's contingency requirement. The Luzon and Visayas power grids have been operating under alert this week as intense heat pushes power demand higher. Cases of measles are rising here in the Philippines, and an outbreak has already been declared in the Bangsamoro region in Mindanao. The Philippine Health Department is encouraging the public to get vaccinated for their protection against a disease that is highly preventable. Ara Perez has that story.
The Philippine Health Department is taking a more aggressive stance to prevent measles, a highly contagious disease, from further spreading. Local health officers have been tapped to bring immunization drives closer to the communities. In Oranbo Village in Pasig City, families don't need to travel far.
Panlaban po rin niya ito para sa katawan niya. Marami na pong sakit na nararanasan natin ngayon.
Nung bata kasi ako, wala kaming bakuna para sa tigdas. At nagkaroon ako, nung elementary ako, talagang sama ng pakiramdam. Huwag nating ipagkait ang pagbibigay ng bakuna sa, dahil karapatan po ito ng mga bata para sila ay mamuhay ng malusog.
Aside from village health centers, health workers themselves are going door-to-door to invite parents, who are also advised on the importance of getting their kids jabbed. This comes amid rising measles cases in the country. Over 1,600 measles rubella cases were recorded from January 1 to April 6, 5 times higher than the 308 cases during the previous year. Almost half of the cases were reported in Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao, which has declared a measles outbreak.
Kami ay nababahala, so parang alerto kami dito. Hindi kami na-alarma kasi pag sinabi nating alerto, alam nating may magagawa pa eh. Marami pong dahilan na pagtanggi sa bakuna. Ang pinakamalaking nakikita ho namin dahilan ay okay lang naman magkaroon ng tigdas kasi mawawala rin. Mga kabayan, yun pong sinasabi nyo, hindi po tigdas yun. Bulutong tubig po yun. No? Meron tayong misconception na ang tigdas ay parang bulutong tubig na hinahawa lang at kumbaga kasama sa paglaki. Hindi po ganun ang tigdas.
Measles can be fatal, especially when it turns severe or when patients experience complications like pneumonia and encephalitis or the inflammation of the brain.
Ang ginagawa lang po ng doktor is yung tinatawag na supportive care. Ibig sabihin, bibigyan ng swero, babantayan, papababain yung lagnat, pero wala tayong magagawa dun sa virus kundi antayin natin na humupa.
Common symptoms include cough, colds, redness of the eye, and rashes, which start from the head down to other body parts. Patients are advised to seek immediate treatment and isolate in a room with good ventilation. Preventive measures include respiratory hygiene, especially the proper wearing of face mask. But prevention remains the best way, which can be done through vaccination.
Hindi naman ibig sabihin na lahat tayong matatanda sa Pilipinas ay kailangan pumila para magpabakuna. Unahin po natin yung mga bata kasi ang pinakamaraming impeksyon ng tigdas na nakikita namin ay sa bata. Kapag pinaligiran natin ng bakuna ang mga bata, matitigil ang hawa at tayong mismong matatanda, hindi na kailangan magbakuna.
Yung fully immunized child po natin na sinasabi natin, ang target po natin is 95%. For the past 10 years, nagpa-plateau na po tayo ng 60 to 70%. Meron 30% po doon na mga bata na hindi natapos yung mga bakuna at sila po yung mga prone po magkaroon ng sakit na mga vaccine preventable diseases kagaya ng tigdas, pertussis, diphtheria kasi hindi sila natapos, hindi nila nakompleto yung mga bakuna po nila.
Health workers are encouraging parents to bring their children to health centers to receive free vaccination. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Finance Secretary Ralph Recto receives the full support of World Bank President AJ Banga for his support to fully digitalize the country's tax system. The Recto met with Banga during the spring meetings of the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund in Washington. Banga expressed willingness to assist the Philippines in its digitalization initiatives to boost revenue generation, underscoring its importance in fixing leakages. The lender will also assemble a team to conduct workshops and assist the Philippine government in the initiative. State-run pension system, SSS, running after firms that are non-compliant in paying the contributions of their employees. Victoria Tulad reports.
This is the first time 28-year-old Mark Isidro is applying for a Social Security System membership. He was unable to sign up in the past because he was unemployed. Mark, who is a tricycle driver now, says getting an SSS membership will be a big help to him.
Para pagtanda ko, may income po o may naiipon din po.
Aside from Mark, SSS registered and updated the membership of other tricycle drivers of Santo Niño Village in Marikina on Friday under the E-Wheels program. John John Pagsambugan participated in the event to inquire about the status of his contributions after he discovered a problem.
Yung dati ko pong amo sa trabaho, pinakuha po niya ako ng SSS para po hulugan daw. Nung nakaalis po ako sa trabaho ko, nalaman ko po na walang hulog.
SSS also signed a memorandum of agreement with the Unified TODA, our Tricycle Operators and Drivers Association, and the Marikina local government to simplify the collection of contributions.
Ang kagandahan nito, ang plano yata ng SSS na magkakaroon ng alkansya sa bawat TODA. Para ang purpose nito, hindi na para kami pumunta sa SSS para magbayad. May kukuha na lang na isang officialis in the following month.
The social insurance program offers various assistance to members, including maternity, disability, and retirement funeral benefits.
Aside from tricycle drivers, SSS also reaches out to other informal sectors to encourage them to register or update their membership. This includes vendors, fisherfolk, and farmers.
Ito yung mga sector ng ating lipunan na napag-iwanan. They belong to the grassroots. So dapat lang talaga tuunan natin ng pansin.
You only need one valid ID to register under the E-Wheels program, which is being implemented nationwide. You may also register via the SSS website. The agency has also intensified its campaign to go after delinquent employers. On Friday, it served a notice of violation against 10 employers in Novaliches, Quezon City, who did not remit the contributions of their employees. Representatives of the employers admitted they were non-compliant, saying they were struggling because of the COVID-19 pandemic.
Kapag ka po hindi nakapag-remit ng contribution yung employer, may epekto po ito sa benepisyong makukuha ng miyembro.
Employers have 15 days to correct their contributions. Failure to do so will force SSS to file a case. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
A mixed bag of price adjustments in petroleum products expected next week following four straight weeks of fuel price hikes. Estimates show the price per liter of gasoline would increase by up to 60 centavos, while diesel and kerosene will both see a decrease of more than 1 peso. Vice President and Education Chief Sara Duterte urged to step down from her posts. Manila Representative Joel Chua made that appeal, asserting Duterte should show decency and accountability amid controversies hounding the vice president and her family. Chua also slams what he calls Duterte's silence and inaction amid China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea, as well as the attacks her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, had thrown against President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The lawmaker asserts Duterte should draw the line and stop being what he called a fence-sitter, pretending to be a full partner of President Marcos. The ANC is still trying to get the side of Vice President Sara Duterte over the matter. Former President Rodrigo Duterte is staying with the political party, Partido Democratico ng Pilipinas. He affirmed his loyalty to the party during its 42nd anniversary Friday evening. The former administration party has seen some members switch to the Lakas CMD party or President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. Duterte said he will only switch parties as a matter of principle.
I am not against anybody going out of the party or of a party and changing party lines. Wala akong ano dyan. I do not have an opinion. I do not have a judgment on that. I do not have anything to say.
The party on Friday voted to drop the Laban from its name. Meanwhile, the party announced it is fielding Senators Bongo, Ronald De La Rosa, and Francis Tolentino for the 2025 senatorial elections. It is also including former actor Philip Salvador in its potential lineup. the president's wife dismisses speculation that she wants to become a senator. Liza Araneta Marcos says the rumors began when she launched a program to provide free medical tests to poor Filipinos. But in an interview with broadcaster Anthony Taberna, she claims she only initiated a program to do something productive in between teaching in Iloilo City. The First Lady notes speculation over her supposed political ambitions already arose during her husband's term as Ilocos Norte governor. If the First Lady does decide to seek a Senate seat next year, she will be competing with the president's sister, Senator Amy Marcos, who is seeking re-election.
So we go to Love for All. And then, they say, kasi tatakbo ako, ganyan-ganyan. Sabi ko, para ang layo niya na. Imagine every election. Tatakbo si Ma'am. Yung asawa ng governor. Talaga, sure na yan. I only registered the last term of Bong. Mag-isip naman kayo ng konti. Extend your brain just a little bit. If I'm not a registered voter, how can I run?